Right, so we just finished a major story quest, so that means everybody in this entire place wants to talk to us. So, what are we going to do first? Well, we're going to go and talk to Josephine, because she's the closest. And I'd like to apologise for any construction work you can hear in the background, and we're going at it all day, and we'll probably be going at it all week, so, you know, apologies, nothing I can do. Right, so, let's talk to Josephine.
And what else did Lady Forsythia say? That she'd rather drown herself than help the Inquisition. Anything else? She said she'd have us flogged alive if we allied with her brother.
That does sound like her.
Cheer up, Josie. We at least have her attention.
You always do find the brighter side of things.
Okay.
We are in the midst of cementing an alliance with Lady Forsythia of Nevara, Your Worship. It's become a somewhat delicate task.
Yeah, her threat does make no sense. I mean, there's no way she could get to us.
She'll have us flogged alive?
I believe she meant flayed alive. Her ladyship tends to confuse metaphors when she's excitable. I dissuaded her from sending soldiers when she learned we'd struck an accord with a brother she's feuding with. Lady Forsythia simply employs a colorful manner of speech.
Okay. Well, that's putting it mildly.
You're rather good-natured about threats of death and dismemberment.
They are chiefly Bluster, Inquisitor. Most of them. But I confess I do miss my staff from the embassy in Antiva. It was always useful to discuss the day's visitors with them.
Why don't you discuss them with me?
I have time. If you'd like to review things with me.
I wouldn't wish to impose.
If it were imposing, I wouldn't have offered.
Well, I admit, there are a few potential alliances it would be good to discuss.
Okay.
Right on the parlor floor. In front of everyone at the soiree. Who does such a thing in front of their guests?
Oh, I know.
Duke of Kellington, apparently.
And then there's Cole's lurking. It frightens our guests half to death. Lord Jenner still won't respond to our letters. And Sarah, can she not find a single overshirt with that mustard taint on it? Then there's Dorian. The man refuses to take anything seriously unless it suits its whim. Not to mention... Oh goodness. Have we been here an hour already?
Mm-hmm. One of these flirt? Nope. Do you always fret so much?
Is relaxing really this difficult for you?
Of course not. Well, occasionally. I didn't intend to go on for so long. You must think me quite the gossip.
I think you're delightful.
Spending time with such an engaging woman is never unpleasant, Lady Montillier.
Goodness. I'm glad I haven't wasted your day. Well, I've taken up quite enough of your time already. Until next time. Your Worship.
Mm-hmm. Oh, we start up here. This is interesting. Now, there should be something... Maybe there's something up here for us to look at as well. I don't see anything. Sometimes there are some extra little things to look at up in your room if you've done something. But guess not this time. Right, so let's head back downstairs. All the way. Can we jump over here? Nope. Okay, we're taking the long way around. Ah, there we go. Main hall. And we're going to go back and talk to Josephine again. Because Josephine probably has more to tell us, but not in the cutscene. I don't get this little airlock. I understand why it's here in terms of like why the game was made, but I don't get it. Like this is a loading screen, in case you pretty much, in case you didn't realize. But yeah. I don't get why it's there. Otherwise. Anyway, yes.
With an interesting development, Inquisitor. A petition from citizens of El Royo. They wish to know what Andraste said to you in the Fade.
They think she spoke to me?
Even Leliana can't trace the rumor's origin. It may be expedient to respond to those asking for Andraste's words.
Hmm. Well... Is this a question? But I never saw Andraste.
It's not Andraste who saved me.
Few people outside Skyhold know it was Divine Justinia who delivered you from the Fade.
You could attempt to tell Varroyo's citizens the truth, though it may not be as inspiring as they hope.
Why don't you tell them I do speak for her? That seems like a good way to get control of something. Like, get them, say... just try and take control that way. I mean, or we tell them it wasn't undrastic, or we tell them nothing. If we tell them nothing, that could allow them to create their own stories about us, which could be just as useful. No, tell them I do speak for her.
Tell the petitioners, Andraste said her herald's word is as her own.
That will certainly make the Chantry take notice, but we shall spread the word.
I like that. Anything else?
A pleasure.
Yeah, we've already done this.
Another time.
Pretty much done all of those questions. I think the more personal question doesn't open up anything new. Or at least it doesn't usually. Did I see that floor flicker out of existence for a second? Probably. But I saw a person there, but I didn't. This person, by the way, I finally figured out what he did after a playthrough and a half. Why are they talking over me? Right. This person over here, basically, there are little things, tapestries. There's one up there that you can find. And little bits of the tapestry, then he tells you the story, basically. That explains who he is. Playthrough and a half, and I finally figured it out. Anyway, Varric, hello. You should be happy with us, right?
I knew Stroud, you know. Not well.
Oh, no.
He led the wardens near Kirkwall. Not many people knew who he was, but the man was a hero when it mattered. He wasn't the first good man to fall to Corypheus. He won't be the last. This story's no good for heroes.
At least Hawk survived.
You must be glad that Hawk made it back in one piece.
Yep. Closest thing I've ever seen to a miracle there. Hawk asked me to tell everyone back in Kirkwall where he's going. Fenris needs to know. Maker, I'm glad I won't be doing this in person. I'd better write some letters. Excuse me.
I do like the constant mentions of Fenris. I know it's just one choice carrying over, but at least it's something that's carried over. Ooh, another thing, he's writing the letters now. I can come back later.
Is this a bad time? I can come back.
No, it's all right. Bills are really not that engrossing.
Oh,
I've been meaning
letters.
To come talk to you anyhow. I never officially joined the Inquisition. I don't know how to do this disciplehood thing. I'm a businessman. Never really followed a chosen one before.
Well, I don't know. What are we going to go for? I'm not the chosen one. Just do what I do. Just be my friend. You can just do what I do. I think that sounds kind of what I want him to do.
There's nothing to it. Just follow my lead.
It's not really that easy. The Inquisition isn't simply another army. You just don't know what you are to the people out there. The Herald of Andraste is a symbol bigger than any of us.
Wait, is it? I thought that was a Canary-only thing. I can't be bigger than myself. What am I to you, then? Let's get some information.
What am I to you, then?
None of this shit makes any sense to me. Is this the end of the world? Did Andraste send you through the breach? I have no idea. You heard the crowd singing after Haven was attacked?
Yes, please don't sing.
Please tell me you aren't going to burst into song now.
Don't worry, I'm not that cruel. I should probably get back to work. Unless... You up for a game of Wicked Grace?
Game of cards? Okay. Well, we'll talk to him. Let's do it.
Sorry, I really need to write some letters. Another time, all right?
Oh. I guess we're not having a game of cards right now. Well, that's fine. We can move on. We'll come back later. Solus, we could talk to him. Is there something else in his room? No. Yes, we forgot. And this thing right here. Way of the Rift Mage. Oh, that's the book that you needed for the Rift Mage quest, which we can't hand in, but, you know, the book exists. Ah, yes, that was the thing I was looking for. The other one at top of the ladder. Okay, let's just quickly grab that. Just want to see what it is. The rotunda and the fresco. Okay, so that's a Leliana Codex entry.
I cannot believe the Grey Wardens could even conceive of such a plan. To seek out these old gods deliberately in some bizarre attempt to preempt the Blight.
Mm-hmm. Don't forget all the demons.
And calling the army of demons. That's my favorite part.
The demons are nothing. They're a tool.
A tool that would have let Corypheus ride roughshod over most of Orlais.
Even if they hadn't, the entire idea is wrong. The Blight is not something one smugly outsmarts. Forgive me. The entire idea is... unnerving.
Touched a nerve there. Yeah. Hello.
The new power.
Anything else?
I heard from Cassandra that it is the magic of the Night Enchanters. If I am not mistaken, the techniques descend from those of ancient elven mages called arcane warriors. I wonder what they would think to see their magic used in defense of the Chantry.
Mm-hmm. What were they called?
I doubt they were called arcane warriors in elven.
The formal name for the techniques you have learned was the Durthena and Nasaline, knowledge that led to victory. Mages who eschewed physical confrontation called it Gilanim Banalvan, the path that leads astray.
What do you know of them?
What can you tell me about the arcane warriors?
They were elite guardsmen, serving as bodyguards or champions for nobles, as I understand. Mages who focused on spirits or the Fade might sneer at their physicality, but never doubted their honor. They were the living embodiment of will made manifest, mind shaping the body into the perfect weapon.
Mm-hmm. I think they'd probably be pleased that it lived on.
I hope the ancient elven warriors would be pleased to see their techniques survive.
I hope so as well. So much knowledge has been lost. Perhaps having something they created carried forward, even in such a different form, would gratify them. Did you need anything else?
No, that's it.
We'll
actually
talk later.
Goodbye.
Although we're going to see if he has anything else to say.
Hello?
Nope. We'll that was a later. Definite Goodbye. Nothing more. Right. Well, let's move on. Now go up these stairs. I think it's Dorian's next. Then it's the first enchanter, who I think we should definitely see if she has anything to say. Dorian's definitely going to have something. Yep.
You have remarkably little here on early Tevinter history.
Mm-hmm.
All
yeah.
these gifts to the Inquisition, and the best they can do is the Malefica Imperio. Trite propaganda. But if you want 20 volumes on whether Divine Galatea took a shit on Sunday, this is evidently the place to find it.
Is this a flirt? Yep, such a critic.
That's the Dorian I know, critiquing every book in my library.
I wouldn't have to if you could find some rebellious heretic archivist to join the cause.
Are there rebellious archivists? Other than you, that is.
If Corypheus ever starts burning masterworks of literature, I'm sure a few will pop up. Did I see something by Genitivi here? I could have sworn.
Oh, all over the place.
What is this about, Dorian?
When everyone returned, they told us about your tumble into the Abyssal Rift. You went into the Fade. Physically went in. You do realize this feat hasn't been performed in over 1,000 years. Corypheus and his contemporaries entered the Fade and began the Blights. In comparison.
Well, I wish you'd been there.
It would have been easier if you'd been with me.
Without question. But I'm rather glad I wasn't.
No sense of adventure. That's surprising.
I've not your talent for survival. And not everyone is as discerning as I. If you can walk in the Fade, others will try to follow. Who knows what secrets Corypheus has revealed? Not all of them will be as lucky as you. What they could unleash. My advice? Keep this quiet. Let them speculate. Too many will see this as a challenge.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, well, I agree. I like having power.
That's a good idea.
There are enough idiots in the world who think if they just use enough blood magic, their problems will vanish. It's exactly the sort of thing I want to stop back home. This I don't need. What I do need is a copy of the Liberalum. I'll wager I can find Corypheus's real name. If I can prove he was a grasping ankle biter with no family to speak of, the luster would come right off. Wish me luck.
Mm-hmm. Did we not hear his real name in our Fade adventures? I think we did. Ooh, another thing to read. Way of the Necromancer. Oh, that's for the other quest that we can't finish now. Hello, Dorian. Anything else?
I'm told you have Alexius researching magic for you. Research is always what made him happiest. Perhaps I'll even go talk to him eventually. One word of advice. If he suggests altering time as a way to solve all your problems, give it a pass.
Okay. Anything else?
Here I thought we were just getting to the good part. So, I assume you're Talvashoth or something like.
Why would you assume that?
If you weren't, you would have split my skull open at our first meeting before I said a word. Centuries of warfare with the Canari do lead to this state of affairs.
You've met Canari before?
You've encountered Canari before?
Canari raids are rather old hat for anyone from the Eastern Imperium. Although the attacks aren't quite the rampaging wars of ages past. Now we're like two angry dowagers who only remember to spit at each other when they pass on the street.
What about in person?
Did you meet any Canari personally?
None who weren't rushing towards me with a sword. I was too busy running in the other direction to say hello. I've met some Talvashoth in my time, however. Mercenaries and a few merchants. They're not the same as Canari. Might easily be a different people altogether.
Mm-hmm. No, we're not that different.
Canari and Talvashoth aren't so very different.
I suppose you are both so very, large.
Mm-hmm. I considered killing you. I want to just see what he says.
I thought about splitting your skull open.
Oh.
I haven't decided yet.
I'll thank my lucky stars then.
Okay.
I should go.
Anything else?
You know where I'll be. The Inquisitor's work is never done, I see.
Did we do the other conversations? I think we did the other conversations with him before, but we could... Well, I don't... No, we skipped him before, I think. Because he had so much to talk about. We'll do it now.
It occurs to me that I barely know anything about you.
Beyond my being a mage from Tevinter, you mean?
Beyond that, yes.
And beyond my being so charming and well-dressed, which is obvious to anyone.
It's obvious to me.
I'm well aware of your finer qualities, believe me.
Of course I believe you. The moment I saw you, I thought, there's a man who knows quality. Now, what was I talking about? Ah, yes, me. I am the scion of House Parvus, a product of generations of careful breeding and the repository of its hopes and dreams. Naturally, I despised it all. The lies, the scheming, the illusions of supremacy. That's Tevinter in a nutshell, isn't it? Needless to say, my family was not happy with my choices.
Mm-hmm. Your family's angry with you?
Why would your family be upset with your choices?
Because I rejected their idyllic plan. If they had their way, by now I'd be married to some unlucky girl from a powerful family. We'd live in luxurious despair, despising each other as I waited to take my father's place in the magisterium. I declined the honor, and thus it's best I'm far from home. Less of an embarrassment that way, you see.
You don't like Tevinter?
I'm getting the impression you don't care much for your homeland.
On the contrary, I care for my homeland a great deal. There's so much potential. Sadly, we squander it. We refuse to acknowledge how far we've fallen because pretending is easier. We pretend the Canari can be beaten. We pretend that we're superior to everyone, even our own people. Not everyone feels that way. I don't. Sadly, we're the minority.
But why do you care?
It just seems so much of what you say about the Imperium is entirely negative.
It might sound that way. For all our faults, my people have many virtues. We are laden with history and culture. Tevinter is where Thedas truly began, remember? We treasure our past and preserve it. You can walk down a side street and find nothing built during the modern ages. And despite appearances, we care deeply about everything. We have no reserve, not in war and not in love. If I truly believed my homeland was beyond all hope, I wouldn't miss it so much.
Careful breeding?
What did you mean by generations of careful breeding?
The great families of Tevinter don't have children. They refine traits, weed out the undesirable, and promote the rest. My mother was chosen for my father because magic runs strongly in her blood. Never mind that they loathed each other. They wanted a son who could become Archon to make House Parvus the envy of the Imperium. They got me. A cautionary tale that you should be careful what you wish for.
So why don't you go back?
Why remain with the Inquisition? Why not go back to Tevinter?
I'm not exactly welcome back home. Not that it matters. I'm quite accustomed to being a pariah. It adds to my charm. I can do more for Tevinter here. If the Venatori succeed, it'll set my homeland back 1,000 years. I'm sure some magisters would disagree. But that's why we kill them.
Well, that's enough for
now. I think I've heard enough.
That's too bad. I never tire of talking about myself.
Okay, so tell me about the Imperium.
I'd like to ask you about Tevinter.
Yes. Everyone outside the Imperium always seems quite fascinated by it. Probably why they come up with so many ridiculous tales. Flying cows over Minrathus. That's madness. All right, that one's actually true, but the cows didn't have wings. I digress. Anything in particular you wanted to know?
Well, Corypheus was a magister.
Corypheus is a figure out of Tevinter history. He was a magister.
Yes, but that was a different time. The Imperium's power was at its peak then. The Civil War had ended. The Magisterium was united, its armies scooping up bits of Thedas like candy. The Magisters who entered the Black City. It was a demonstration of how exceptional Tevinter had become.
But who were they?
No one knows. There's no record of a Magister named Corypheus. All this happened 1,400 years ago, before the Blight nearly wiped us out. There are no records. Today, people half believe it's all just a story. That's what I believed.
But it's not a story.
We have evidence the story is very much real.
But not who Corypheus is. If he even remembers. There used to be families who claimed some of those Magisters as their own. That stopped when the Chantry appeared. Then it was shameful, and the families distanced themselves from the tale. All we know is that some men and women entered the Black City looking for the old gods. What did they find? According to Corypheus, nothing. And only he could tell us more.
Okay. So is blood magic common?
Just how often is blood magic used there?
Oh, not at all.
Not at all.
That's what any magister would tell you. They'd be convincingly offended by the notion, too. Of course, what people call blood magic here and what we consider blood magic are two different things.
What do you call it?
What's considered actual blood magic in Tevinter?
Blood magic isn't inherently dangerous. Using your own blood or that of a willing participant, what's the harm? The problem is that what's permitted only gets you so much power. And what if you need more? You always need more. That's where we get into sacrifices and demon summoning. None of that is done. Not officially. Behind closed doors, it's a different story. Real blood magic can give you an edge, a leg up against your opponents. It's safe to assume that any mage of rank does it. The rest are quietly shut out of power, to put it bluntly.
So no Templar intervention?
You'd think the Templars would object.
I imagine they did, long ago. Once, their investigations might have been sincere. Then their balls were cut off. Too inconvenient. Nowadays, only the friendless are accused. And most of them probably innocent.
No one disagrees?
There must be some mages who oppose this.
Of course. I do. And I'm not entirely alone. Occasionally, there'll be a magister who makes noise. And then the reform talk begins. All very patriotic. Meanwhile, that magister will be quietly shunned. Chances are, surprise, it's learned he was a Maleficar all along. Most learn to keep quiet. Me? I enjoy the allure of pariahhood.
Okay. What about slavery?
Anyone who talks about the Imperium mentions slavery. It's the center of the slave trade.
Ah. That is true.
And did you have slaves?
Not personally, but my family does and treats them well. Honestly, I never thought much about it until I came south. Back home, it's how it is. Slaves are everywhere. You don't question it. I'm not even certain many slaves do.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's not like that here.
Well, we don't have slaves in the south.
In the south, you have alienages, slums, both human and elven. The desperate have no way out. Back home, a poor man can sell himself. As a slave, he could have a position of respect, comfort, and could even support a family. Some slaves are treated poorly, it's true. But do you honestly think inescapable poverty is better?
Treated poorly?
Is that what you call it? Treated poorly?
Abuse heaped upon those without power isn't limited to Tevinter, my friend. I don't know what it's like to be a slave, true. I never thought about it until I saw how different it was here. But I suspect you don't know either. Nor should you believe that every tale of Tevinter excess is the norm.
Okay, let's move on. Do mages truly rule there?
It seems strange that an entire empire would be ruled by mages.
Strange? Why are you less qualified to rule than some tart with a fancy crown? Actually, the fiction in the Imperium is that mages don't rule. The Magisterium rules. That magisters are all mages is considered a convenient technicality.
Oh, all right. The Magisterium?
What is the Magisterium, exactly?
The upper house of the Imperial Senate, and the only part worth having a seat on. Those seats are split among the circles of Magi, the Chantry, and the Major families. All Majors now. It's odd that outside the Imperium, you use Magister like it applies to every Tevinter Mage.
What are you, then?
If you're not a Magister, then what are you called? No special title?
I'm an Altus, which is almost as good as a Magister, depending on who you ask.
And an Altus is?
I've never heard of an Altus.
Upper class. Those families who trace descent from the Dreamers, the first prophets of the old gods. If you're a mage and you're not Altus, then you're later. Lower class. If you're not a mage at all, you're Soperati. That's everyone else. We do love our fancy words.
Mm-hmm. Okay, what about the Arcan?
I thought the Archon ruled over the Imperium.
Well, yes. Technically, he can overrule laws passed by the Magisterium, but that never happens. Even so, he gets to appoint new Magisters, which means all the families vie madly for his favor. Thus, the Archon gets invited to all the parties. The truest path to Tevinter influence, let me tell you.
But mages do rule.
If it's a fiction, that means mages do rule, then.
Yes and no. Let me put it this way. Mages do rule, but not all mages are equal. If you're not from the right family, chances are you don't rule anything. Maybe you're even a slave. The idea that anyone could be a mage, however, keeps the masses placated.
Is that true?
Can anyone be a mage?
Technically. The potential runs mostly in bloodlines, but it's been known to happen. More importantly, commoners believe it can. Tevinter legend is chock full of mage heroes from humble origins. So they hold out hope. Someday my son or my son's son will be a mage. Someday. Poor sods don't realize that means he'll be a quaestor at the arse end of the 100 billers, at best.
Is that bad?
Being a quaestor isn't a good thing.
I imagine the average non-mage likes to think so. Counting numbers and shuffling papers all day is better than many occupations after all. If you're a second-class citizen among a pack of piranha, however, your outlook changes.
Okay, I want to ask something else.
Let me ask you something else.
Of course.
So, the Imperium has a chantry.
There's an Imperial chantry, isn't there? With its own divine?
You people aren't supposed to talk about the Black Divine, are you? If you mention him outside the Imperium, people make that face, like you're urinating in public. But yes, we do have the chantry, or a version of it. Night and day comparing it to yours.
Okay. Is it really that different?
Is the Imperial chantry so different from ours?
Not in theory. The main difference is in the whole magic is meant to serve man, not rule over him business. Back home, ruling the unwashed masses is serving them, for the good of the Imperium. Perhaps it started with good intentions, but these days it's academic. The circles are in command.
You have circles?
There are circles of magi in the Imperium?
We don't have dismal little mage prisons, if that's what you mean. They're academies, prestigious ones. We have templars as well, but they don't cancel spells or whatever your templars do. They're soldiers.
They don't use lyrium?
Ha! As if there'd be any left for them. They watch for abuse of magic, yes, but only those who are weak or who fall out of favor get dealt with. Mostly they enforce their magisterium's edicts. The Chantry smiles and nods from the sidelines.
Okay. The Black Divine?
Do you really call him the Black Divine?
We don't call him that, oh no. In the Imperium, he's the true divine. The woman sitting on the Sunburst throne is some backwater pretender. It all stems from a disagreement over Andraste. Marvelous, isn't it?
A disagreement?
Why would they disagree over Andraste?
It's not my field of expertise, but the Imperium believes Andraste was a mortal woman, a mage. Down south, they say, no, she's the bride of the Maker, ascended to his side, divine provenance, a blah, blah, blah. We feel better believing Andraste was one of us. Makes executing her less damning, you see. So we elected a man as divine, the South declared war, and we've been feuding cousins ever since.
Your divine is male?
So the Imperial divine is always a man?
All the better to distinguish him from that other one, yes. Don't think there aren't a number of female magisters who bristle at that. Why can't they be divine after all? Same reason you never see a man on the Sunburst throne. Because that's how it's always been done. Excellent reasoning.
Are you religious?
Do you consider yourself Andrastian?
Ah. The big question. It might surprise you that I do consider myself Andrastian. I simply do not believe in the Chantry. It is a relic, whether back home or here in the south. Something from a bygone age desperately clinging to relevance. It's not an opinion that makes me popular.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, I agree with you.
I share your opinion, actually.
That's not surprising, considering what the Inquisition represents. I'll say this. I may not believe in the Chantry, but I believe in you.
In me?
Oh, nice of you to say.
That the Maker sent you, whether through Andraste or fate. Cassandra is not wrong. You saw that in the future, without you, Corypheus prevails. You are our bulwark against evil.
Mm-hmm. I don't know.
I'm not sure about that, myself.
Doubt is good. I like doubt. It will keep you sane. Me? I've seen too much to believe I know everything. The world is bigger than I. Even bigger than you. It laughs at all the things we think we know. The Maker doesn't need me to believe. But I do. The thought of no one at all watching out for us is too frightening.
I want to ask something
else. Let me ask you something else.
So many questions.
This last one. Could Tevinter be an ally?
I'm wondering if the Imperium would be a useful ally.
I'd think you'd be more concerned whether or not they'd support the Venatori. They won't. At least, not officially. They'll disavow all knowledge of dangerous cultists. Secretly, many magisters will rejoice at the idea. And if the South falls to chaos in the meantime, all the better.
Is that smart of them?
It would be in the Imperium's best interest to help. Surely it could use allies.
I think the Imperium gave up on the idea of allies a long time ago. We've been fighting the Canary for what? 200 years off and on? It's a point of pride that we go it alone. They'll sneer at the South behind their silk handkerchiefs and say, you've had it easy for far too long. Let's not forget that the Inquisition seems to be an arm of the Orlesian Chantry. Anathema so far as they're concerned.
But we're not.
We're not part of the Chantry. The Chantry opposed the Inquisition's formation.
You think that matters? Don't be silly. The Herald of Andraste. Your very title smacks of the Southern Chantry. You may as well be a heathen. I think they're far more frightened what you'll do if you succeed.
All right.
That's all I wanted to know.
Fair enough.
I should go.
Try not to kill anyone without me.
Okay, we learned quite a lot about the magisters there. Fiona, I don't know why we have a health bar for you. That's very weird. Could that go away? Nope, okay. Hello, Fiona.
I'm told you gave the Grey Wardens another chance, Inquisitor. Would I have done the same, I wonder? Forgiveness can be difficult. I hope the Order values what you've done and gives you no reason to regret it.
Mm-hmm. We've already done you were a Grey Warden. Yeah, I'll carry on. It. Didn't really have anything to say. Let's see if we can get far enough away that we stop targeting her. I'm going to talk to Vivienne next. There we go, it's gone away. There's the person who trained us, the Night Enchanter. Vivienne will probably say something to us about that as well.
It's a noble calling, the Night Enchanter. You have joined the ranks of the most select mages. You should be commended. So few have the discipline necessary.
You're a Night Enchanter.
I didn't realize you were a Night Enchanter, Vivienne.
Of course I am, darling. Night Enchanters serve in the highest echelons of the Chantry and Circle. Where else would I be?
Mm-hmm. We are the best.
It was an easy decision to join the finest mages in Thedas.
It always is, my dear. But not everyone can manage it.
Okay. Anything else?
You walked physically through the Fade. Please tell me what you remember.
Well, it wasn't the first time.
I was physically in the Fade at the Temple of Sacred Ashes, too. You didn't ask about that.
Darling, you didn't remember anything. Questioning you would have hardly been productive. No one else has physically entered the Fade since the Magisters assaulted the Golden City. Oh, I'm positively envious right now.
Okay. Anything else?
Yes?
Nope. Okay. We could try and help the circles, but I don't really want to do that, because don't like circles. See, here's the kind of things that you create. Like, you get this, you get the 12 pieces here, then you go talk to that dwarf down there, and he tells you a story about it, basically. Right. Don't need to speak to her because she's a tranquil and she's just going to tell us about research things. Up here we have Leliana. Hello.
Inquisitor. I have been thinking. You remember everything now, yes?
Uh-huh.
The explosion at Haven. The Fade. Escaping the breach. In your report...
Yep.
You said Justinia was with you, but only you emerged in the end. Why? Why were you the only survivor?
What? I'm just gonna say I had to save myself. See what she said. Oh, she saved me? I tried to save her? I guess I'll just say I had to save myself, I guess? We'll see how that goes.
It was her or me. I'm sorry.
I see. Thank you for being honest with me, Inquisitor. Her message to me. I failed you too. I'm not sure I understand what that means. Did you say anything else? Anything at all? Please, if you remember.
We're just going to say she's dead, why dwell? That's what we said last time. Stick to it.
It does you no good to dwell on her. She's gone.
It's not for you to decide what is and isn't good for me. There are no answers in the Fade. Only illusions. A warped mirror. Justinia has never failed me. I was her left hand. Now she's dead. I failed her.
Okay. Anything else, Leliana?
I hear the mages will now answer to the Inquisition. And when you no longer need them, will they be locked up and forgotten again? Most would treat their dogs with more kindness.
It had to be done.
It was necessary to keep Thedas safe.
Just as the circles kept them safe, the Chantry sees controlling the mages as the only solution. I hoped the Inquisition would be less... narrow-minded.
Oh, we've got some more things we can talk to her. So this is all questions, okay. I've already done the investigate stuff, I think. So, special. I watched you die for me. Yes, we did watch that.
In Redcliffe, you sacrificed yourself so that I could return here.
Of course I did. One small life in exchange for a second chance at history. I always loved a bargain.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'm just, happy it worked.
Well, it worked. That's all that matters to me.
If only everything were that simple.
Okay,
I'll leave
we'll leave that there. Right. Oh, she might have something else to say.
You've joined a fellowship with a distinguished history. Night enchanters have long served the divine.
Mm-hmm. I didn't do it to serve.
I didn't choose this path to serve anyone.
Where you go on the path is one thing, where it starts is another. These traditions were forged by the Chantry's most trusted mages. That cannot be denied. But no matter, you have chosen well, and are in good company.
Actually,
I had friends who
we were just told they were served by elves.
Who served at Justinia's side, who died with her. It's good to see new mages keeping this flame alive.
Mm-hmm. I'll leave you to your
okay.
work.
Okay. Another question.
I expected the hero Ferelden to be at Adamant, but he was not with the other wardens. He studied the Blight after killing the Archdemon, and may know something that could help us. If you like, I can have agents look for him.
Good idea.
That sounds like a wise choice.
I'll make preparations in the war room. Now, was there anything else?
I'll leave
just one more question, probably.
So Varric knew where the champion was all along. That's the last time we sent Cassandra to interrogate.
I'll leave you to your work.
Okay, she just has some other stuff like that to say. Cool. So we could find the hero of Ferelden. Now, the next place I want to go is over here to speak to Cullen. Let's see if I... Yeah, I can go over the wall. Perfect. Little shortcut. Works out for me. Let's go have a chat. Hello, Cullen. What have you got there?
As leader of the Inquisition, you... There's something I must tell you.
Spit it out.
All right.
Lyrium grants Templars our abilities, but it controls us as well. Those cut off suffer. Some go mad, others die. We have secured a reliable source of Lyrium for the Templars here. But I no longer take it.
You stopped.
Why not?
When I joined the Inquisition. It's been months now.
Mm-hmm. Why didn't I know sooner?
Months? You didn't think to tell me this sooner?
Has it mattered?
I don't know, has it?
After what happened in Kirkwall, I couldn't. I will not be bound to the Order or that life any longer. Whatever the suffering, I accept it. But I would not put the Inquisition at risk. I've asked Cassandra to watch me. If my ability to lead is compromised, I will be relieved from duty.
Mm-hmm. I don't approve.
You shouldn't have done this in the first place.
I have to do this. What future can there be outside the Order if I don't try? I believe in this Inquisition. I would serve out of loyalty, not blind obedience.
Mm-hmm. Must be another way.
But this, risking your life, your sanity, it can't be the only way.
The Inquisition's army must always take precedence. I will consider what you said.
All right. Another conversation.
First the Templars, now the Grey Wardens. Both devoted their lives to fighting evil. Now they serve it.
So if I was possessed?
If I was possessed by a demon, would you?
I would rather not consider it.
Okay.
That's all for now.
That's all.
Another time then.
Talk
was there something
again?
You needed?
Nope. That's all.
That's all for now.
Should you require anything, I'll be here.
There was maybe a little bit more conversation about Samson, the Templar who's causing trouble, but we don't need to hear about that just now. I think it's just a side quest, but if it's anything more, you'll see it. Right, Blackwall just ran out this way, but there's some more stuff in here for us to find, I think. Still think. Oh, we got something back here. There we go. Stale boy's letters. Okay. Yeah, I remember there was something up there. Where did he go?
Have never had better.
Yes, exactly. But where did you... There you go. Hello.
Someone I knew once described Adamant to me. Adamant is, and always will be, the Order, he said. A guardian on the edge of the abyss. The lone soul that stares into oblivion and doesn't waver. That's what Warden Commander Clorel tried to be. Well, they all tried to be. None of the Wardens we saw wavered. They gave their lives willingly. They died for us. and Corypheus twisted their sacrifice to make it his own.
Mm-hmm. Well, Clorel's pride is to blame.
Clorel thought she was the only one who could save the world. He was arrogant.
But her intentions were pure. Her desire to protect was so great it led her astray. It's not right. To want to do good, to be good, and have that turned against you.
Mm-hmm. Nothing is perfect.
You can't expect everything to go well all the time.
No. But we still have to try, don't we? Even Clorel, she had to try. It's not the armor or the trappings of the Order. It's not the joining. At the heart of it, all a Warden is a promise. To protect others, even at the cost of your own life.
Okay, where did he go? Also, what's this? Oh, that's buying mounts? Yeah, let's not do that. And where did he go? It's back in here. Hello.
This is just... it's something to keep their hands busy. I'm grateful you tracked me down when you did. As exciting as wandering the woodlands was, this is better. It's good to be part of something so important. Something that could change things.
What about the Wardens?
The Grey Wardens are huge and important. You're part of that.
True, but without a blight on the horizon, everything the Wardens do feels like waiting. This, the Inquisition, is what matters now. And I'm grateful to be a part of it. You are who you choose to follow. Someone told me that once. Took me years to understand what he meant.
Mm-hmm. Why follow at all?
And some of us choose not to follow at all.
We can't all be born leaders. It was a chevalier who said those words to me. A powerful man, but never without honor. A true knight. We met as competitors in the Grand Tourney. He left me with that advice before we parted. Put aside his own ambitions to help me win the melee. I don't think I even thanked him.
Grand Tourney?
What is this Grand Tourney?
You've never heard of it. The Grand Tourney of the Free Marches. It's a spectacle. Song, dance, wine, every amusement you can imagine. But the greatest part is the contest of arms. Prove yourself in the Grand Tourney, and you can make your fortune.
What happened?
How did he help you?
There were 100 men on the field, each one fighting for himself. The knight and I had forged an alliance. It was just the two of us, and we took all comers. The goal? Down as many opponents as possible. He always let me deliver the final blow.
Mm-hmm. Why did he do that?
He must have wanted something from you to help like that.
A pupil, a squire, someone to teach and to mold. He saw my potential. When it was over, he offered to mentor me, to teach me to become a chevalier like him. And I, young and stupid, turned him down flat. I just won the melee at the Grand Tourney. I didn't need him. I should have gone with him. Perhaps things could have been different.
Regret is useless.
Don't waste your time on regret.
Regret has its uses. It comes from reflection and stops you from making the same mistakes twice. But I'm older, hopefully wiser, and I think I've chosen the right person to walk with.
Okay, you want to tell us anything else?
I've been meaning to thank you. There are 100 things that need your attention. You didn't have to take the time to help me, and yet you did.
Mm-hmm. It also helped their cause. That's finding all of the Grey Warden artifacts.
The Inquisition must do many things to gain support.
Of course, you would have considered every angle, every advantage. I've never been more certain of my decision to join you.
Mm-hmm. I'm just hiding the bad reasons.
Leliana makes sure my sordid secrets never come to light.
Well then, I won't pry. I prefer to go on believing only good things about you.
Okay.
Nothing right now.
Talk to him again.
I'm here.
Nope, nothing else. Right now.
Perhaps in a bit.
We could talk to him a bit more about some of the things he just refused to talk about before, but I don't think he likes us enough yet. Right, who's next? We've got Nobody over. We got Maneve over here. Who's Maneve? Hello.
We have a chance, a real one.
Okay. Yep. She wasn't important, apparently. We'll just leave. I think we've got Cole and Sarah in the pub. We've got Cassandra sitting over there, and we've got Iron Bull sitting over here.
You got your
let's
wish,
go to Cole and Sarah first. Scout Harding's there, but she won't say anything. Ooh, something to read. There we go, another one. Ooh, there's Iron Bull. And Krem, but Krem won't say anything. Let's talk to Iron Bull. Hello. If we can get the right angle. There we go.
Again. Again. Come on. This is why the Kune doesn't like women fighting. I should have asked Cullen. Good one.
Perhaps you can take over.
Mm-hmm. What are we doing? Just hitting them with
Another
a stick?
A training exercise to master your fear. I heard about the nightmare at Adamant. Sounded big.
I'm just gonna hit him.
All right.
There we go. Oh, yeah. Time, demon. Who's stuck in the fade, huh?
That's right, let it out.
You fought in that siege. Every demon in Adamant wanted to tear you in half.
I bet, you demon assholes! And who killed you? That's right, Iron fucking Bull! I needed that. Thanks, boss.
You like it rough?
Didn't know you liked it that rough.
Only from you, boss. Only from you.
Okay, let's go and talk to him again. I know Cassandra's right there, but we're gonna get to her. Right, Iron Bull. Iron Bull is interesting though, because he doesn't necessarily always have conversation things for you. Because you have to, if you kill dragons, he'll talk to you more, and we haven't killed any yet. There we go. You wanted to get drinks?
You said we should go get some drinks and meet your company?
Yeah, come on. It'll be fun.
Uh-huh.
Ah, good. We're not drinking alone. How you doing, creme de la creme?
Your worship. I'm so glad he has someone new to hit with that joke.
Mm-hmm. Does he ever stop?
Is he always like this?
I'm afraid so. The chief loves his nicknames.
Hey, when I was growing up, my name was just this series of numbers. We all give each other nicknames under the Kune.
They ever wear shirts under the Kune, chief? Or do they just run around binding their breasts like that?
It's a harness, Krem.
Yes, for your pillowy man bosoms. Let me know if you need help binding. You could really chisel something out of that overstuffed look.
Mm-hmm. And the rest of your crew?
Who are the others?
A lot of the chargers went looking off for stronger drinks. Let's see, who's left? We've got Rocky and Skinner there. And over there are Stitches, Dalish, and Grim. Crazy bunch of assholes, but they're mine.
Right, so how did you get here, Skinner?
So how'd you join the chargers?
Killed some people.
Skinner didn't take kindly to nobles testing their new swords on the elves in her alienage.
Bull took me in. Now I get paid to kill shams.
This is actually really good behavior for her. She's not marking her territory or anything.
Mm-hmm. Grim, what's your story?
Grim, is it?
Grim doesn't talk much. I'm pretty sure he's the lost king of some small country. Or chieftain. Something like that.
Okay, where are you from, Rocky?
Were you born on the surface, or are you from Orzammar?
Orzammar. I got exiled. Stupid noble crap. Also, I accidentally blew up a bit of the shape rate.
Rocky's one of our best sappers. He can take down enemy fortifications faster than a golem.
I'm also working on my own version of Kunari black powder. I've almost got it.
Yeah, you really don't.
Okay, why leave your clan, Dalish?
Why aren't you with your clan?
Our keeper thought I should see the world a little.
Dalish don't have Templars, so they can't have too many mages in a clan at once.
Now, sir, you know I'm not a mage. That'd make me an apostate.
You carry a staff, Dalish.
It's a bow.
A bow with a giant glowing crystal at the tip?
Yes, it's for aiming. Old elven trick you wouldn't understand.
Mm-hmm. So you're a healer, Stitches?
I take it you're the company healer.
Yes, first time I ever picked up a sword was when the blight hit Ferelden. Never put it back down.
He makes a potion that'll put you right back on your feet after even the toughest fight. It tastes terrible, though.
That's because it's a poultice, sir. You're not supposed to drink it.
Mm-hmm. So are they any good?
They can fight.
We can fight, can't we, boys?
No man can beat the chargers, cause we'll hit you where it hurts. Unless you know what's happened with those cards and loose your skirts. For every bloody battlefield, we'll gladly raise a cup. No matter what tomorrow holds, our horns be pointing up.
Thanks for coming by, boss. Glad you could meet some of my team.
All right, interesting bunch he has there. Anything else?
Pleasure as always, boss.
See you later, boss.
Okay.
Nice talking with you, boss.
Next person is up the stairs, round the corner. It's going to be Sarah. I think we will encounter Cole first, but I want to go to Sarah.
I hope I can help somehow. Maybe cleaning?
Oh,
hello,
Inquisitor. I joined. Sutherland, your worship. I saw some bandits, so I came to warn people. I'll let your warriors know and then stay out of the way.
Oh, okay. Well, we could maybe give him something to do. Sarah is round here in her own little alcove. Right, hello.
Heard what went on in that fade thing. What you think went on. Can't even start to believe that business.
Mm-hmm. Well, seeing is believing.
It's hard to describe. Guess you had to be there.
No friggin' thanks. Some people are still there. Stroud, yeah? Lost a serious mustache there. And in trade. A busted down bunch of wardens. And they're always weird. Usually, bad stuff happens first, so you're glad when the hero shows up. But wardens are the wrong way round. They're the good thing that means a bad thing is about to happen. Like in Denerim, when the blight ended.
Mm-hmm. Well, I only care if they're useful.
They can be whatever, so long as they're useful.
A lot of people expect them to be a thing, though. And a lot of people are real good at using them. Blackwall's nice, though. Different from the adamant ones. Need more like him.
Okay, anything else?
Hey, hello? You. I have an Inquisitor favor to ask. Just a little thing, really. A little march around for some of your people. It's nothing for you, right?
Okay, I'm listening.
All right, let's hear what you've got.
Jump right in, huh? I like that. It's a Red Jenny thing. I got a tip that some noble stiffs are arguing over Vachel. Land squabble. They're getting little people beat up. So I need you to go to your big table and send some people to walk through town.
Just walk through?
Just walk through. Easy, right?
I'll have some people take
a
look.
All right, Sarah. I'll have someone look into it.
It's fun, right? Being important without doing a thing. Well, not much of a thing. Not everything has to be torn skies and ancient assholes. Every little thing makes a difference somewhere.
Anything else?
Getting serious about mage stuff. Magic. Things. How about not so much? Just asking for not so much magic. Great, yeah?
Okay, carry on.
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Anything else?
Hey, it's you again.
So why did you really join me?
So you like to have fun. The Inquisition seems an odd fit. Why are you really here?
What do you mean? To help people.
I don't believe you.
You're mostly a criminal. Helping is only a side effect.
So, some people don't even help by accident. I've got questions, right? And all this stuff is going on with the Chantry. Andraste. But it's fuzzy. I want to see if it's all really real. I just don't know if I want to really know. So I'm selfish. It's all for me. Count yourself lucky, I guess.
I'll be back if I need you.
Go on.
Right. Well, let's go talk to Cole, see if he has anything to say. And then it's Cassandra, let me know I think. If you find one. Hello.
No. But you like demons. I enjoy the company of spirits, yes, which is part of why I do not abuse them with bindings. It isn't abuse if I ask. Not always true. Also, I do not practice blood magic, which renders this entire conversation academic.
Hello.
He won't bind me. He's a mage and he likes demons, but he won't help.
I'm a mage. What's wrong?
Why would you want Solas to bind you?
So I'm safe. If Solas won't do the ritual to bind me, someone else could. Will. Like the Warden Mages. And then... I'm not me anymore. Walls around what I want. Blocking, bleeding, making me a monster.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's true for everyone.
A mage using blood magic could conceivably do that to any one of us, human or demon.
You should ask Solas to bind you too, and then someone can bind him.
Mm-hmm. We'll figure something out.
There has to be some middle ground between do nothing and bind Cole with blood magic.
Indeed. I recall stories of amulets used by Ravani seers to protect spirits they summon from rival mages. A spirit, wearing an amulet of the Unbound, was immune to blood magic and binding. It should protect Cole as well. The resources of the Inquisition could be used to find such a talisman. Good. They will not take me.
Okay. Well, we could go and have a look for that at some point. Let's go and talk to Cole again. He'll be back at the top of the pub. Another song.
Who advised before her?
Not a new one this time.
Why was it not the first enchantment?
There we are.
She went.
Hello.
It started out helping, taking the fear away. I won't take too much. I am not that.
Okay, you've done some odd things.
I've heard about some oddities here in the keep. Was that you?
Yes. Maybe. What was it?
You're hoarding daggers?
Someone found a barrel full of misplaced daggers. Was that you?
They were safer there.
Well, that's something else.
Let's talk about something else.
All right.
I'll talk to you later. We'll leave it then.
How do you know?
All right, so he's not saying much. One person left to talk to. Out the back here. We've just got to talk to Cassandra. Then I think we've talked to everybody. Who have we got? We got Iron Bull, Varric, Solas, Dorian, Night Enchanter Lady Vivienne. We have Sarah. Oh wait, is this guy still here in the wall? I just saw that there. I could click on someone through the wall. Oh, no. We have Sarah, we have Cole, and I think that's everybody, yeah. Blackwall. Just Cassandra. Hello.
Writing does not come naturally to me, as I'm certain you can imagine.
Okay. Love poetry, I assume?
Let me guess. You're composing a love poem.
What's she doing? Not even if my life depended on it.
It's not that hard.
Yes, it is. Poetry takes finesse. It takes grace.
Do you think you don't have those things?
Historians will one day ask what happened at Adamant Fortress in the Fade. I wasn't there, but others were. Their accounts must be recorded.
That could be used against us.
But you write could be used against the Inquisition.
You're worried what I'll say about you, I assume. Do not be concerned. I am a poor writer, but not unaware of the weight my words might carry. I still don't know what to say about the spirit of the divine. The Chantry teaches us that the souls of the dead pass through the Fade, so it could have been her, yet even so.
It was a spirit, nothing more.
I think it was a spirit, that's all.
Perhaps it saw Justinia's soul and admired it enough to carry on her wishes. I hope that's true. I want to believe it. When they told me you were physically in the Fade, I was terrified for you. The last time such a thing happened, we created Darkspawn. We created Corypheus. The world needs to know the truth this time. No more legends lost to the ages.
Okay. Anything else, Cassandra? Right. Out there. Hello? Anything else? Ooh, we're at the war table now.
Something Maybe. In particular you require?
What are you doing?
You could tell me what you're doing here.
I suppose I do need your help. We saw so many Red Templars at the assault on Haven. Perhaps all that was left of the Order. What we didn't see was Lord Seeker Lucius. Indeed, I've seen no hint of any Seekers amongst the Red Templars, or anywhere. I have a growing suspicion Corypheus has imprisoned them.
Couldn't they be dead?
Why imprisoned? He could just as easily have killed them.
Not easily. But yes, they may be dead. But the Seekers began this war against the mages. They cannot have simply vanished. There must be a trail we can follow, yet so far I have only discovered hints.
What if they're infected?
But they could have ended up just like the Red Templars.
Seekers do not use lyrium. I assume Corypheus gained control of the Templars by corrupting the lyrium they were already taking. To do the same to a Seeker, you'd have to force the lyrium upon him. That may be what happened, but it couldn't have begun that way. We're missing a piece of the puzzle, Inquisitor. I need to find it.
They might be his allies.
Wherever they are, they might be working with Corypheus willingly.
I refuse to believe that without proof. I don't expect you to understand. I cannot even claim that rescuing them would be beneficial. They wouldn't look kindly on the Inquisition. But even so, if there's a chance... If we can spare resources to follow up on these leads, Inquisitor, I would appreciate it.
Okay, we can do that. Definitely. Let's head down here. Through this one. Through again. Through again. Right. Go all the way back to Cassandra. She is quite a long way away. Wish we could use our dash, but we can't use it in Skyhold. Just a low enough drop that we don't have to go into full the drop animation. Perfect. And there she is. Hello.
I understand if resources cannot be spared to help search for the missing Seekers, Inquisitor. Still, it could involve a threat we are unaware of. There may be a use in looking.
Okay.
That's enough for now.
As you wish.
So she has nothing more to tell us. I am going to go quickly to the war table to see if there's another conversation, but I think we have talked to literally everyone we can. There's no one in the jail. There's one person in the jail. There should be one Grey Warden, but I don't believe they actually show up. There's the garden. There is the mother in the garden who tells you about things, but she's not that... she just gives you some background on what side quests you're to be doing, basically. Let's go up here. All the way to our war council. And if it gives us the war table. There we go. And have a look at what we're going to do next. So do we have any more traits to get? We don't. So in the war table, the next big quest we have is Wicked Eyes and Wicked Heart. It says we don't have enough power, but I reckon if we were to finish up a few of these random things, we would definitely have enough power. What else do we need to do?
Well, in Adamant.
Well, we need to do all of these side quests to unlock the extra abilities for our companions, which will definitely give us extra quests to do and extra actual quests to do. Like, I believe the, at the very least, this one in Orly, the, which one? The battalion for Sarah and Virgil unlocks the line where eventually you get more of Sarah. There's the one with Cassandra unlocks more things with her to do. There's also some of these side ones, like all the little pyramid ones. Some of them I think I might do off camera, like in here. Might do make contact into Emerald's graves off camera. There's not a lot that's vital to the plot in there. Liberate Empress de Leon is a little bit more plot heavy. Could go there.
I've arranged a port between the Marquis and the Dowager.
And yeah, the Venatori activity in the west is one that I unlocked just so that we could get some resources. But it doesn't have a lot to do with the main plot either. It has a puzzle in it that goes across six areas, but it's not a very interesting puzzle the second time round. Western Approach has a story bit which is very self-contained, and we could do that on its own kind of thing. Yeah, and the Exalted Plains has a story bit which is also kind of self-contained, which we could have a look at. A lot of these have kind of secondary areas which are more interesting than the main area, which we could have a look at once we get there. Well, apart from that, there's not a whole lot left, but think about what we're going to do for next time.